I wanted to bring my own values around environmental issues into my career, and I had an opportunity and I took it. Why do I think my students benefit? One of the things that I believe is true about this course is that environmental accounting and sustainability accounting impact all the various sub-disciplines of accounting, from the way you create accounting information systems where you're collecting data for decision making and reporting in the firm, to the internal management decision making process where management accounting comes in, to the external reporting, which is the financial accounting arena, and then there's also the auditing area of accounting where independent auditors come in and audit a firm. So because the environmental issues span across that, this course has a capstone flavor to it. And it's a way of students being able to tie all of their educational information, the things that they've learned in the various accounting classes, and kind of apply it to a particular accounting issue. The other thing I would say about why this course might be important to students is I don't think the accounting profession can ignore environmental issues for much longer. And at some level, the profession in this country is ignoring it. I talk to professionals, and they're not real sure what it is. Okay, so they say, well, what is environmental accounting? And it always surprises me that they say that, because it just seems like environmental issues, first of all, are prominent. And second of all, it's so easy to make the link that if a company is impacting the environment, either positively or negatively, there's a potential reporting implication. And I think in many ways that while there isn't necessarily a professional track that students can step into at this moment, I think there will be. And I also think it's important that students kind of pick apart the mainstream conventional accounting model, which we do in my course, to understand that it's not a perfect system, that there is a, I guess to use my colleagues in Scotland's word, there's sort of a moral implication around how we account for things. We account for things if there's an economic transaction. Basically, we don't account for things if there isn't, okay? That's, in a sense, a moral statement. Profit is good is a moral statement. We're all into growth in this country. All of the business courses that they have are going to promote that concept of more profit is better, more growth is better, and yet look at the impact on the environment. And an organization that has a particularly significant negative impact on the environment will show a profit, but nowhere in that calculation of profit are the externalities, the social costs of the environmental damage that they do, unless there are mechanisms to bring those costs in. Some organizations are required to report what's called contingent liabilities if they think there may be a liability at some point in the future. Then they're required to report, but they're reluctant to report bad news unless they really have to. I was talking about profit being a good thing, and I think it's really important that students walk out of this university understanding that profit is not necessarily always good and growth is not necessarily always good. And to have that in their business program is also really important.